गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी क्लास सिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 14, दैट इज़ वाटर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द वाटर साइकिल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी हाउ द वाटर इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर अस। सो हेयर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट इफ वट हैपन वैन इफ रेन इज हैवी और इफ नो रेन एट ऑल। So first, what if it rain heavily? So as you know, the time duration and the amount of rainfall varies place to place. It rains throughout the year, while there are places where it rains only for a few days. So as in our country, most of the rainfall occurring during the monsoon season. So it help us to get relief from the hot days. So sowing of many crops also depend on the arrival of monsoon. But the excessive rainfall may lead to many problems. So the heavy rain may lead to rise in the water level of the river, lakes and pond. So it may cause floods. So during floods, there may be the crop, field, forest, villages and the cities are submerged by the water. So the flood caused the excessive damage to the crop, domestic animal and property and human life. So during floods, the animals which are living in water carried away by flooded water. So in this way, these animals were died in the flood water. So rain also affect the animal which are living in the soil. So these are the effects which can be caused due to the heavy rain. So here, in contrast to this, what happen if it does not rain for a long period of time? So as we know, rain is very important for us. So if there is no rain for a year or a more than a year, the soil continues to lose water by evaporation and transpiration. But this water cannot be bring back if the rain does not occur. So the soil become dry. So the level of water in ponds and well of region goes down. So the groundwater may also become scarce. So this may lead to drought. So in drought, there is very difficulty to get food and fodder for human as well as animal. So in newspapers and in magazines, you already seen that there is large amount of difficulties has been faced by the people living in these area where is no, there is no rain at all. So you have to try to find out by talking your parents or seeing in newspaper or magazines what are the difficulties that can be taken or the faced by the people who are living in the area where less or no rainfall take place. So in this way, we can say that the water is very important for us. So the question is, how can we conserve the water? So the water is available on earth in small fraction, which is also used by plants as well as animals and humans. So the most of the water of the earth is present in oceans and it cannot be used directly. So, as the level of the groundwater decreases drastically and this cannot be used anymore, the total amount of water on the earth remains same, but the availability of water for use is very limited and it is decreasing with overusage. So, the demand of water is increasing day by day because the population increases. So in many cities there is long queues for the collection of waters are common sight. So more and more water is used for production of food and by industries. So mainly these are the factors which are responsible for shortage of water in many parts of the world. So it is our duty to take care not to waste water but the use water carefully. So there are number of methods by which we can save water. So here we will discuss about a scientific method that is called rain water harvesting. So what is rain water harvesting? So here the rain water harvesting is the one way by which we can collect rain water and store it for later use. So the collecting rain water is called rain water harvesting. So mainly the basic idea behind is catch water where it falls. So as we know, when rainwater falls on earth, the mostly the areas are covered with concrete roads and buildings. So water flows into drains and after that water goes to river or lakes. But a lot of effort can be taken to require this water back into our home because water didn't seep into the ground. So here are the two techniques by which rainwater harvesting can be take place. So number one is rooftop here rainwater harvesting. So what is rooftop rainwater harvesting? In this system, the rainwater is collected on the roof to a storage tank or through pipes. So then this water is filtered because it contains soil before it's used. So instead of collecting rainwater, we can also send this water to the pit in the ground. So which seeps into the soil to recharge or refill the groundwater. The another option is allow the water directly into the ground from the roadside drain that collect the water. So in this way, we can collect or save the rainwater for the many uses. So here we had completed the chapter number 14, that is water, and revise this chapter and stay connected for the queries. Thank you.